Hello. Oops. Hello.
Stephen King once wrote that.
How's that, babe?
I think the game used to be a little louder.
A little louder on the game?
Yeah.
Alright. Hello, Mario. Hello, Super Puffins.
Can you make the game even louder?
Even louder?
Yeah.
Really?
It's a quiet game.
Really?
Yeah.
How about that? Hey Rev, hey Steel, hey Ashel. This is a never seen game, Keith. This is actually a game that's never been played or seen yet. This is the first time anybody has seen footage for this game yet. I've seen it before, but I got this imported from Germany. It was the only place this was released, and it was only in 3 stores. A lot of people didn't even know it came out. Alright, let's start this game up. This is gonna be a really good game.
Stephen King once wrote that nightmares exist outside of logic, and there's little fun to be had in explanations. They're antithetical to the poetry of fear. In a horror story, the victim keeps asking why, but there can be no explanation, and there shouldn't be one. The unanswered mystery is what stays with us the longest, and it's what we'll remember in the end. My name is Alan Wake. I'm a writer.
Oh shit, that's his name!
I've always had a vivid imagination, but this dream unsettled me. It was wild and dark and weird, even by my standards. So yes, it began with a dream. Following a typical nightmare pattern, I was late, desperately trying to reach my destination, a lighthouse. For some urgent reason, I couldn't remember. I'd been driving too fast down a coastal road to get there.
Uh-oh.
I'd seen the hitchhiker too late.
And I'm waiting to kill that guy.
I was convinced they'd put me in jail and I would never see Alice again.
Where'd he go? You guys!
Suddenly, his body was gone.
Where did he go?
I was in shock from the crash. I could hardly stand my feet.
Where did he go? No. Hold LB to sprint Alan Wake. Okay. Now the coolest part about Alan Wake is that you get to watch the Twilight Zone. They have full episodes.
I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
The best part of this game is that they have full episodes of the Twilight Zone, like Max Payne. I'm going this way.
The bridge had collapsed. I'd have to find another way to the lighthouse.
I would have to jump over. That was the only way to win.
I had to go to the lighthouse. I knew there was something important waiting for me there.
Actually, I had to jump over the bridge again. Oh, look at this guy. Missing. Oh, who is... Is that Max Payne? He's back! He's back alive! Oh shit, there he is!
Recognize me, do you, Ryder? You think you're God? You think you can just make up stuff?
Thank you, Doug Jones.
You don't even recognize me, do you?
Bye-bye.
You think you can just make up stuff?
Did I win? Is he still alive?
It would be a single readable sentence in your books if it wasn't for your editor. You'll never publish another one of your shitty stories.
He's making fun of Alan Wake's books. This guy really doesn't like Alan Wake's books that he writes.
You missed your deadline!
Uh-oh.
Damn.
Oh, okay.
You can't stop.
Come and get me, come and get me. Kill me. Oh! Alright, kill my guy. Oops. Alright, hit me. Yeah, good job. Oh, where'd he go?
I realized that the hitchhiker was a character from the story I've been working on.
Game audio is way too low. Still? Huh?
Your voice is a lot louder than the game.
Really?
Yeah. Can you turn the game up on your desktop?
How about that? This is as loud as it goes. How about that? Is this good? People are saying that's good. That's not good? How about this? Look in the trash, Alan Wake. Go, go, go. Now he can jump. Alan Wake is good at jumping. Come on. Go. Go, go, go.
Hurry.
I am. I'm going. All right, here we go.
There's no time to lose.
can't shoot him. You can't shoot him. He's invincible. Oh, no. Oh, he's dead.
I was trapped. There was no way out.
I wish that my character Garfield came alive instead. This is a show. This is a good show.
The cabin was a death trap. I had to get out.
It gets better at season two. It gets better later. Uh-oh. There. Go this way. Is the lighthouse talking to me?
You are hurt. You should go into the light. You are only safe there.
Fine. Okay, this heals you.
Well done. I have something important to tell you. It goes like this. For he did not know that beyond the lake he called home lies a deeper, darker ocean green, where waves are both wilder and more serene. To its ports I've been. To its ports I've been. Do you understand?
No.
Follow my light. Enter your dream to teach you. The darkness is dangerous. It's sleeping now. When it feels you coming, it will wake up. There's no time. I can only show you the most important thing.
And then wake this in.
The hitchhiker has been taken over.
Do you like green eggs in him?
You can't hurt him now. The darkness protects him from all harm. Only light can drive the darkness away and make him vulnerable again. Here, take the light.
Oh, give me the flashlight. Boom!
Flashlight toward him and
yeah! Yeah! You don't like that! You don't like that! Uh-oh. There! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
Now the darkness no longer protects him.
Yeah!
Inside, controlling him. He can't be saved. He's still a
you can't be saved!
Here, take
yeah! Take the gun. You can't be saved! Die! Shoot him, Alan Wake! Yeah! Alright.
Good. You've done well. Remember what I've taught you. That is all. I will give you back your dream now.
In the nightmare, a terrible darkness was taking over the world. The lighthouse was the last place on earth.
Okay, Alan Wake. I will give you a dream back. Bye-bye. I love you, Alan Wake. Yeah, shoot him! Thank you, Jordan. Oh, he's coming to get me. Boom. 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 Boom! Oh, look at this guy. Boom! Boom! Oh, here he comes. Here he comes. Oh! Oh, fuck! How about I forget how to dodge? Oh, there we go. Alright, boom! Boom! Okay, he's out of there. Alan Wake is almost dead. Oh, flare gun.
Can you turn on subtitles in the game?
Subtitles?
Yeah, does the game have that option?
You can't hear it still?
That would just be nice to have.
There. Yeah. Thank you. Whoa! Whoa! Hey, one fish, two fish, red fish, blue fish. What do you see? I see a brown bear looking at me. You wanna fuck with me? Huh? Wait, don't use that. Use this. Fall him off the cliff. Oh, Alan Wake. Look at this. Alan Wake is on a billboard. I can keep this up. See, this is why people didn't know about this game. They spent the marketing budget actually to advertise inside of the game Alan Wake. Now this is an evil tornado. We have to run from that. Oh! 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 Is it still going? Yeah, it's still going. Is it over? I have an idea. It didn't work. Go in there.
Baby, just another nightmare. Everything's fine. You dozed off.
Right. Anything more than dozed off would be news for everyone.
Cheer up, handsome. We're here.
He's awake. He woke up.
Let's act like we're on vacation. Go stand next to that old gentleman there. I want a shot of you with the town in the background.
Sure. I'll even give you a title for the shot. A city boy, moments before he got eaten by a bear.
Alan Wake, you crazy.
Hi. Hello there. You picked a good time to visit our town. Deerfest is just 2 weeks away.
Oh, Deerfest. Huh?
Did you hear that, honey?
You have a lovely wife. If you don't mind me saying, I'm Pat Bain, by the way. Nice to meet you.
Yeah, I'm Alan Wake.
I won't pretend I don't recognize a famous writer such as yourself, Mr. Wake. A pleasure.
This collision is bugging out.
I hope this isn't too presumptuous of me, but I'm the night host at the local radio station. Any chance I can get an interview?
Look, Mr. Main, I'm on vacation. In fact, I'd appreciate it if we could keep my being here just between the two of us.
What is she holding?
Fair enough. You can trust me to be this one. Not a hard man to track down if you change your mind, though. I hope you two have a lovely holiday.
Is he holding something? He's holding nothing. Alright, we're almost to town.
Very nice. I got a couple of really good ones. And I see you made a friend. That's cute.
Right. Yeah?
Hey, bestseller. How's my favorite writer? Are you there yet?
Very.
The collision on the boat is bugging out like crazy.
Just say the word, and I'll hop on a plane and come make sure that you're left alone, Al.
No, Barry, we're fine.
Great. Great. Just want to make sure you can relax and recharge. So, how is the place? Has it gotten your creative juices flowing?
Barry, we're just settling in.
Okay, Al. I'll call back later to make sure you're doing okay. And you call me if there's a problem, okay? Okay. I'm just looking out for you, buddy. Talk to you later.
I love you too, Barry.
You know he's going to be calling you every 5 minutes.
Barry is Barry. I can always turn off the phone.
What did I tell you?
Text message from Barry. He says hi to you,
damn
too.
Yuppies.
Whoa, this guy hates Alan Wake.
Alan, we're here. Come on, let's get back to the car. We need to stop at the local diner to get the cabin key from the landlord. A Mr. Carl Stuckey. He's waiting for us. I'll go fill her up while you get the key. I'll pick you up here in, say, 15 minutes?
Sure.
Alan hate.
Alan?
I hate Alan Wake.
I love you, too. Go on. I promise to be.
I hate Alan Wake. He's just talking to himself. I hate Alan Wake.
I'd forgotten there were still places like...
Alan Wake!
Towns where everybody knew everybody.
Welcome to the O'Dear Diner.
Hi, I was wondering if you could help me. I'm looking for...
Mr. Wake. Alan Wake. Oh, God! I am your biggest fan. I know people say that all the time, but I really am.
There's a cardboard cutout of Alan Wake in the diner.
I'm looking for Mr. Stuckey. Carl Stuckey?
Carl? Of course, Mr. Wake. He must have gone to visit the restroom. He'll be back in a moment. I can't believe it. I've got all of your books. I got the cutout from the bookstore when they took it out of the window.
And you keep it here. Well,
okay. Oh, that's where it came
good
from.
For you.
What book am I promoting? Alan Wake, The Sudden Stop.
Just don't blame me when you fall in love, because it'll break your heart when you have to leave.
Rusty here is no longer human. Nothing but black coffee under a thin layer of skin.
Yeah, that makes two of us.
Oh, thank you, Bubble.
Are you staying long, Mr. Wake? I can't believe it. I'm having a conversation with Alan Wake.
Yeah, Alan Wake. There he is. It's Alan Wake.
Are you on your own, or is your wife with you? I can show you the town if you want. I get off work at 6.
Whoa.
Thanks, Rose. We'll be sure to keep that in mind.
She's trying to get with Alan Wake. Look, there's two. Which one is the real one?
Right. So much for a quiet vacation.
Oh, dear fest. Home of annual...
Do me a favor, Sonny. I could really use a tune right now. Coconut, number 6 in the jukebox.
Okay.
I do it myself, but both of my legs have gone to sleep. Bad circulation. Yeah.
Okay.
Are you serious? Coconut again? You disgust me. Call yourself a rocker. Unbelievable.
Ha! Put coconut on? I'm putting on coconut.
The lime in the coconut. Drink them both up.
Just because we're brothers, don't think I won't
it
murder
does that.
You in
get
your
stuck.
Sleep.
Yeah, you need to give it a good solid whack.
Oh, you have to hit it.
Yes. That's my favorite tune. Coconut.
Shut your mouth, you demented has been. If I had my hammer, I'd shut it for you.
Coconut. Hit it. Hit it, Alan Wake. Hit this shit. Fucker. Play that song. Play that shit. Yeah, play that shit. Put on coconut. God damn it. Put that shit on. Put on that goddamn stupid ass song. Hit that shit. Yeah. All right, coconut.
Now that's what been talking about yet?
This is it. I've died and gone to hell.
I told you guys, this is a good game. What's happening over here now? It's the log lady. This is log lady.
I think I can handle it, ma'am. I didn't want to wait. I wanted to find Stucky to get the key and get out as soon as possible. The waitress was giving me a headache. Overeager fans always did.
So I'll die if I go in there? She's like Log Lady, but she has a lantern instead. Going here?
Hello? Mr. Stucky?
Carl couldn't make it. Unfortunately, he was taken ill. But I have the key for you and instructions on how to get to the lake.
Okay.
I wish you a good stay.
Evil. Evil.
I'll come by later to check how you've settled in. And to meet your wife.
Evil.
I insist.
Thanks.
Shoot her. Alan Lake. Yep. Now we're going to Alan Lake.
Cauldron Lake is a special place. Very inspiring.
Call me Alan Lake.
You got lucky this time, young man. You can hurt yourself in the dark. This really ought to be fixed. And then I must remind Sarah to change the lights at the station. It's been too long already.
Even that sounds better than your singing.
Oh, he fell asleep. Oh, he's back. He's back.
Splendid, splendid. Damn hernia. It swells up like a balloon if I lift anything heavier than a spoon. Yeah. Splendid, splendid. It's been a long time, Tom. Good to see you.
Hey, you wouldn't happen to have a bottle on you, would you, Tom?
I'm not Tom. I'm Alan Lake now.
Local musicians. We're waiting for Dr. Hartman to come pick them up. They wandered off from his clinic at the Cauldron Lake Lodge.
All right, I'm leaving.
Bye, Mr. Wake.
That was one of the most intense sequences of the game.
And the directions.
My hero. I got some flashlights, just in case.
Hey, wait! Mrs. Wake! Your keys!
But who gave Alan Lake his keys?
That diner was a real nut house.
Can you believe this place? This would make a wonderful setting for a book.
We're supposed to be on vacation, Alice. I'll figure it out when we get back home. Okay?
Okay. We can talk about this later.
Batman here on KBFF.
I didn't want to talk about it. I wanted to bury my head in sand.
Here's another one of my favorites to go with it.
Once upon a time, I was a successful writer, but that was a long time ago. I hadn't been able to write a word in 2 years, not since my last book.
And now the weather. It's gonna be a clear night, so you folks in the big city might want to look up every once in a while and see those stars winking down at you. It's pretty dark out here, but they'll light your way.
This song is from David Lynch movie too.
Wow.
Oh, we're not going to Diver's Isle.
It's something, all right. Don't worry, honey. I'll get you inside safe and sound before it gets dark. And I've got the flashlight.
I know. I'm okay.
Alice had a phobia. The fear of darkness. I wanted to make sure we were inside with the lights on before sunset.
Oh, she has a fear of darkness. Going in and wake. Bird Leg Cabin. This is where he lives. It's called that because there's hundreds of birds always here. No, this didn't just come out. This came out about 30 years ago.
Here we go.
But there was only 3 copies.
Come on.
Come on, open up. Oh, open up. Come on. Play coconut. Come on, you stupid ass door. Play coconut. There.
It's dark in there. We need lights.
Sure thing.
This is like me and Leah. Leah goes, it's dark in there.
No.
It's not even dark. The light isn't even doing anything.
Hello? Anyone here?
Hello? Hello? Bird? Play coconut. He already got ratted out on the radio.
Hi, Pat. It's Rose.
Why, hello, Rose. What's on your mind?
I know who that famous artist was. It was Alan Wake.
I know that. It's Alan Wake.
Generator had been connected to the power cable.
The lights are on. Good work, honey. I'll freshen up a bit and start settling in.
Okay. I'll look around a bit.
Sure thing. Have fun.
It was a beautiful place. I told myself I could rest here, sleep here, and forget about my work. I thought we could be happy here.
Dang. So the only way they get electricity is from this generator. Let's see what's going on in the house.
A shoebox filled with books by Thomas Zane sat on the shelf. I'd never heard of him before.
Oh, I know Thomas Zane. Yeah, he wrote, didn't he do Lord of the Rings?
Alan, I'm upstairs. I have a surprise for you.
Hello?
Surprise!
Alice? What is this?
What is this bullshit?
I have a small confession to make. I thought maybe you could write here that a change of scenery would get you past...
Damn it, Alice! You...
Whoa!
Hey, hey,
whoa!
Just hear me out.
There's a local doctor, Dr. Hartman. I read a book of his. He has a private clinic here. He specializes in helping artists.
Maybe so now you want to get me committed?
No!
Whoa.
It's not like that. That's not...
Whoa!
Alan? Alan?
He's right there. He's right in
just
front of
don't.
You.
Don't! I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice!
Whoa.
God damn it!
I knew she wouldn't follow me in the dark. I needed some time alone to think things through.
Alan, wake. He's angry.
Damn it. Alice?
Oh, the house is eating her.
Alan, where are you?
Help! I'm over here by the lake. Right now, I'm Alan Lake.
I haven't seen this many birds since Alfred Hitchcock's The Birds film.
Alice?
Hello?
Alice?
Play Coconut.
Oh no!
How did she fall in the lake?
Keep going.
Missed a big twist, babe.
Waking up in the crashed car felt like I had woken from one nightmare and entered another. I couldn't remember how I got there. All I knew was that something terrible had happened to Alice. The phone was dead. I'd have to find help on foot.
One second, guys. Really?
Among Alice's things was a book, The Creator's Dilemma.
Oh, The Creator's Dilemma.
Dr. Emil Hartman. Seeing the book brought back my fight with Alice. I didn't like it, and I didn't like the guy's smug face on the cover either.
He reminded me of Thomas Zane. And I hate that man.
Whoa.
Okay, I'm ready.
The gas station was my best bet. They'd have a phone I could use. It looked like a long hike through the forest to get there.
What? Where the hell did Wake's car go? Wait, what happened to the wife? Where did the wife go? Did she die? She was in the lake and then he was in the car and the car fell. How did we get here? Is he awake or asleep? Is he dead or alive? Is the wife alive? Or did she die? Is it a book or real life? Oh, here's the light. He tells you funny stuff.
Hello? Is someone there?
It's me, Wake. I'm the light.
The loose sheets of paper were pages from a manuscript entitled Departure. That was the name I planned to use for the next novel I had never gotten started. I was named the author. I hadn't written it. I couldn't remember writing it. In the scene on the page, the hero was attacked by an axe murderer in the woods at night.
That's what happened in his dream. Huh? Wake attacked by birds. Find this page in nightmare difficulty mode. Wait, what? You have to play on the hard mode? Or you miss some of them?
Departure by Alan Wake.
Oh, good job, Alan Wake.
The man turned to face me. His face was covered in shadows. It was hard to make him out in the darkness of the forest that surrounded us. But the axe he lifted was plain to see. It glistened with the blood of his victim. He grinned madly. The shadows were alive, distorting his features. It was a scene from a nightmare. But I was awake.
Oh. Alan Wake. He writes this really big and he doesn't even fill the whole page. He's kind of wasteful.
The Taken stood before me. It was impossible to focus on it, as if it stood in a blind spot caused by a brain tumor and eye disease. It was bleeding shadows like ink underwater, like a cloud of blood from a shark bite. I was terrified. I squeezed the flashlight like my life depended on it, willing it to stop coming any closer. Suddenly something gave, and the light seemed to shine brighter.
Whoa, ho, ho, ho. Okay.
For a long time, the dark presence had been weak, sleeping. Nothing but a half-forgotten nightmare or a shadowy flicker in the corner of an eye in the forest at night. Not real enough to properly exist, and yet too evocative to fade away completely. Now it was waking up. The rider, like a fly caught in a spider's web, each jerk and kick vibrating the strands that led deep into its lair. It was aware of him now, and it could use him. All he'd need was a little incentive.
Okay, Alan Wake. Oh. Oh, damn, that's a... Huh? Do you keep these? I must have played this before on here and it just keeps them. Oh shit, Thomas Zane is in love with Barbara. I always suspected. You found the manuscript pages. I do remember that it's hard to find the pages. They want you to just like walk into the middle of the woods and like find pages.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Magic light? Where's the magic talking light? Save me. Where's the book? What happened to Thomas Zane? Is he alive or dead?
The lights up ahead were a good sign. Maybe I wouldn't have to hike all the way down to the gas station to find a phone.
No, Alan Wake, that's where Thomas Zane lives. Your greatest rival.
Anybody there? Please, I've been in an accident.
Hey! Hey, you!
Phil!
There's been an accident. I need help.
Deposit.
Listen, I need to...
Premium cabins for rent in...
He's evil!
Oh, hell.
Carl Stuckey.
Pleased
to meet you. Non-refundable
reservation
deposit required. Fair and square.
He's evil, Alan Wake. Alan Wake, wake up. Hey, I found a book. Hey, read the book.
For a long time, the dark presence had been weak, sleeping. Nothing but a half-forgotten nightmare.
Oh, wait, we read that one already. Wake attacked by birds. Oh, now I love this part. I love this part.
I heard them before I saw them. Swooping down from the sky and screeching as they came, I spun around just as the cloud was upon me. For an instant, I stared into 100 dead eyes, black pearls glittering in the darkness. I raised the flashlight and the swarm exploded like fireworks. Feathers burned, turned into ash. I couldn't hear my scream above theirs.
Hey, when you're right, you're right. Hey, when you're right, you're right. Alan Wake knows all about how to write good books. Oh! No, not the deposit. No. Oh. Run, Ellen, wait. Yeah.
I had to figure a way out of this. Any second now, and Stucky would be knocking on the door with his axe like Nicholson in The Shining.
This is like being at Jack Nicholson's house on set of The Shining. Pick up those batteries.
During your trying.
1 second, monster. I have to use this.
In.
Yes.
Great Falls Sheriff Station. Help me out.
Hello? Hello?
The fuck is happening out there?
You can see the sights and keep those molestos.
And then wake, you die. And wake, you die. There goes that. Wait, maybe we could have just stayed in the house. It just went down there. Nothing really bad happened. Probably would have just been safe if I just stayed in there.
The bulldozer had gone over the cliff with the office. I hoped Stucky had suffered the same fate, but I wasn't planning on staying to find out.
Uh-oh. Oh, fuck. Who's this guy? Shoot him in the lake. Yeah. Now shoot this guy. Boom! Boom! Boom!
My head pounded with a concussion. I'd never fired a gun outside a shooting range, and now I just killed someone. Or something. There were no bodies. They just disappeared. If I was dreaming, it felt real enough to make me sick.
Alan Wake is so calm. I just killed somebody. Two people, actually. And I almost got knocked off a cliff in a house. And my wife fell in the lake. It's all good, though.
Eerie hand-painted graffiti was revealed by my flashlight. Someone had hidden a chest of supplies near it.
Oh, the flare gun. Thank you, Mr. Claw. This is a top five game for you?
The last place I wanted to go, but I had no choice. I had to get to the gas station.
This is one of those games, I think I played this maybe 12 different times, but I've never actually beaten it. I remember when they were hyping this up, it sounded like it would be a lot different than it actually was, too. They weren't really talking about it like a shooter at all. But it makes sense that it was a shooter. It's just guys that make Max Payne. Oh, I got another book. I got another page. Wake finds pages. Oh, I like this part.
At first, I kept finding the pages as if by accident. The book I couldn't remember was either a terrible and true prophecy or an act of creation that had rewritten the world. I began to hunt the pages feverishly, for they held the answer to the mystery. With it, I could save myself. With it, I could save Alice.
Oh, okay. Now, Alan Wake, jump into this. See how strong he is? fuck was that?
What the hell was that?
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
Jump in. This is why they call him Alan Lake. Oh. Kay died immediately.
What was that?
Oh, that is true. That's a river.
When I saw the river below, something uncoiled itself inside my head. I realized that I'd have to find a way across. I didn't even want to look at the water.
Get up there, Alan, wait. Oh, evil man, evil man. Watch out, evil man coming up.
I want something special to eat.
Stucky was still out there, in the dark, stalking me.
He was a better swimmer than I was. Even though I'm called Alan Lake. Oh, there he is, get him, get him! Yeah, yeah. Oh, this guy's throwing axes now. Boom, boom. Ooh. The shooting works really good. He actually has some fun gameplay parts. I think with this game, it's just there's like a ton. It's just a ton of shooting, I think. That's how I remember Alan Wake going down. Can he climb? Okay, you can't climb. You can't climb. This way. Is Alan Wake like Luigi's Mansion? Well, Luigi's Mansion is scarier. Luigi's Mansion went more for a straight horror approach.
Taken. They're taken.
The taken are filled with darkness. Alan Wake went for a more comedic approach. I would have to be really good at the game to get through this window. Oh, what was that? Come on. You got this, Alan Wake. Get through that window. Come on. I think this is the part where I always get stuck. Yeah, I always get stuck at this part, and I turn the game off. You took damage from that, Alan Wake. Go drive this. He can't drive. I forgot. Try Ask Madden. I think that's not in the first Alan Wake. Thank you, Justifine.
The staircase was broken. I had to make my way up some other way.
Whoa.
There was was no power. There was bound to be a generator somewhere at the logging site.
I see it blinking. Oh, it's the evil man. Boom! Oh, that didn't work. What the fuck? Shoot! Kill him! In this game, double A's are really powerful. But also, these double A's are very... It's a very, very shitty brand. They run out of juice almost immediately. Oh, Paige, here we go. TV in the gas station.
I stepped into the gas station's garage. It was dark and quiet. The place was a mess. It looked like someone trashed the place or that there'd been some kind of fight. Light spilled into the room through an open door at the back, and I made my way toward it. Without any warning, I was blinded by a bright light. An old portable TV on the shelf had come alive by itself. Impossibly, I could see myself on the screen, talking like a madman.
Is he just spoiling the whole the storyline of the game? Is Alan Wake just picking up the storyline of the game before it happens? Alan Wake, you ass. Why are you spoiling the game? Oh, I got a shotgun. He wrote the game? They wouldn't let Alan Wake write a game. Come on now. Boom. That almost took him out. That almost killed him. This is very scary.
Well, I was just outside for a breath of fresh air, and what a night. I know most of you are probably in your beds by now, but if you're still up and around,
I'm up.
Take a moment. Step outside for a spell and breathe in deep.
Okay, I'll be right back.
The weather is absolutely still. The sky is crystal. The forest is quietly breathing along with you. Do you listen?
I did it.
I'm a night owl, and it's on nights like this I wish I wasn't cooped up in the studio. Makes an old man like me wish I could just roam wild. But here I am, and it would keep you company all night long if I weren't. It looks like I'm not the only one staying up late. Caller, you're on the air.
Hey, Pat, it's Maurice Horton.
Hello, Maurice. What are you up to?
Don't fucking talk to Maurice.
Oh, isn't it beautiful out there?
Sure, but Pat, the reason I called is that Toby heard something rustling in the undergrowth and took off after it, and I couldn't find it.
Probably a rabbit.
Sure. Toby loves rabbits.
Well, sure.
Anyway, I figured that, you know, if anyone runs into Toby, they could grab him. My number's on his collar.
And Toby's a friendly dog?
Oh, Toby loves people. Usually he comes back, but when we were...
You guys, I gotta hear the sound.
It sounds like he went pretty wild there. Great dog, but just dumb for his own good.
Well, Maurice, it's out there now. Hope Toby comes home soon.
Okay, we have to find Toby.
You have a good night now.
We have to find Toby. There's a new objective. Apparently the dog chased a rabbit, and now we have to find him.
Oh,
Oh, new page, new page. Wake lies to the sheriff. Well, he's just spoiling the storyline. Maybe I don't want to read these pages anymore.
The gas station was closer now. Its light welcoming in the darkness.
Paul makes the best dogs. Hmm. State. Belly Burster is the best with no
contest. Burster Dog
is second best. The famous dog is...
Go, Alan Wake, go. Go. Find the doggy. Doggy. Doggy, are you out here? Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Shoot that guy, shoot that guy. Doggy. Toby. Where are you? Safe haven. I'm going this way. Oh, get that page, get that page. Yeah, oh fuck. Boom. Run, run. Go, go, go. Stay away, stay away. Stay away. Go, go, go. They can't come in the light. Oh, that saves you. It's fucking Energizer batteries. It actually is Energizer. Damn, Energizer sucks ass. Energizer runs out in one in about, they have a 10 second lifespan. Do you think Energizer was trying to like make the batteries last longer? Why is the zombie telling me that he doesn't eat salad? Where are you? I'm gonna shoot you. I have a shotgun. Here we go. Here we go. Boom! Oh! Don't ever fuck with Alan Wake. He needs to upgrade to Duracell, though. Oh, this is my favorite part. All right, get ready for the TV show.
Science. It bestows immortality on those who advance it to elevate all of mankind. Newton, Einstein, Sagan, princes among men. But the price for such a legacy is steep indeed. In Night Springs.
All right, here we go.
Tonight's episode, a quantum suicide. If our lives are already written, it would take a courageous man to change the script. Having called a press conference, Dr. Barclay Colvin is about to demonstrate that very courage.
Ladies and gentlemen of the press, I am Dr. Barclay Colvin, and I'm glad so many of you could join me here at the Moorcock Institute. Tonight, I'm going to give a practical demonstration of the many worlds interpretation.
As you can many see, worlds,
this
okay.
is a loaded 9mm pistol. It shall be part of a thought experiment. And now, a real experiment, known as a quantum suicide.
Did he say suicide? Is that a real gun? He's kidding, right?
Please, please, stay calm. There is... no risk. Observe what occurs when I place the weapon
against my own forehead. Now, you might think this round is merely a dud. Not so. Observe the flower pot.
Oh, shit.
I myself cannot be harmed with this gun. With each pull of the trigger, two new realities branch off. One in which the weapon didn't fire, and one where it did. With my machine here, I have ensured that this reality is always the former. I have bestowed upon myself quantum immortality. Under no circumstances can this gun kill me.
So wait. What you're saying is that every time you pull the trigger, in another reality, you die?
Yes, of course, but that's completely trivial. There's an infinite number of things that could happen at any moment, and they always do happen somewhere. The point is,
oh no!
One thing did not happen.
He unplugged it.
Here,
you're insane, Colvin.
Insane!
Hey, was this thing supposed to be plugged in? I stumbled on it.
You fools! Gaze upon quantum immortality.
Oh no! Oh my god, he unplugged the machine!
Poor Dr. Colvin. Filled by his own hubris and the ignorance of the masses. Perhaps he should have left the crate unopened, the decaying atom unobserved. Curiosity often kills the cat. Night springs.
Oh, that was a good episode. I remember the show being a lot scarier. I thought the show was scary for some reason. Oh, that's gonna fall on my head. That's falling on my head.
It can be dangerous. It requires patience.
This is falling on my head. Yep.
The engine.
Right. This is falling on my head. Maybe I can shoot. Boom! Oh! No, wait! Let me reload! 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 Ow! Alright. I got this. I don't think you can actually shoot that down.
It can be dangerous. It requires patience.
Oh no.
Shoot that guy, Alan Wake. I'm sick of that guy. No. Oh. Boom! More gas? Oh! Oh, he's fast! Oh, he's confessed! Oh! Shit! Shit! Run! Run, Alan Wake, run! You can't win! Oh, he's fast! Shoot him. The batteries run out. Oh, get him! Yeah! Fuck, he's still alive! Shoot, yeah!
Stucky's body vanished, leaving behind only a lifetime of nightmares to come. Assuming I'd reach the lights at the gas station alive.
Take that, Stucky. Now hit this open. almost to the gas station.
I recognized the parade big float deer I had seen in Bright Falls when I first arrived with Alice.
Why is his eyes so big? Shoot the eyes? It is, that's, I feel like that's gonna be one of the final bosses.
After the insanity I had just experienced in the darkness, the lights of the gas station felt comforting. At least for a moment, the sane world reasserted itself.
I guarantee I'm gonna have to face that giant. I'm gonna have to fight the giant deer as a boss.
I had to get inside the gas station to find a phone to call for help.
Your cough is so loud. Huh? Your cough is so loud.
Why is my cough so loud? Why am I so loud? Usually I'm too quiet. Now I'm too loud.
The garage was a mess. It looked like someone's place. Or that there'd been some kind of fight.
Oh, let's watch my TV show.
All right. I'll keep writing. Outside, there's only darkness. Outside the cabin, outside the story, there's only darkness. I can feel her presence in the dark. Just now, I could smell her perfume in the room. I'll reach her. I'll fix it up. I'll bring her back. The story will come true. If I stop, she's lost.
I don't believe this. It'd been me on the TV, talking crazy. Was I losing my mind?
Now Alan Wake's on the show. Now Alan Wake has to write a book in the show to bring his wife back. Oh, the big stuffer. They got big stuffer in here. Oh, dang, what is this? Garlic and vinegar chips, okay. Cheese and cream. Oh, I got some new windshield wipers. Anti-rust. What am I looking for? Get that beer. Drink that beer. The annual Deer Fest. Raffle. Pie contest. Live music. For the children, Bucktooth Charlie. Whoa, who's Bucktooth Charlie? That's going to be one of the final bosses. You have to fight Bucktooth Charlie. Find a phone. This is a phone.
Bright Falls Sheriff Station.
I'm saved.
Thank God, Sheriff.
Sheriff Sarah Breaker, you are...
I'm Alan Wake, but listen, I was in a car crash. My wife, Alice, she's missing.
Calm down, Mr. Wake.
We were staying in a cabin on the island, on Cauldron Lake.
There's no island on Cauldron Lake, not since the big eruption in the 70s.
Please, I can take you there, okay?
You look like you've taken a pretty bad knock to the head. Are you okay?
Alan Wake, listen, is crazy.
We'll figure this out. Please get in the car. We'll swing by the lake, and then we'll go to the station, okay? Mr. Wake, have you seen Stucky, the guy who owns this place?
Oh yeah, I killed him.
I realized I couldn't tell her what had happened in the forest. She wouldn't have believed me. And then she wouldn't have helped me with Alice.
I shot him like 20 times. The island go. Alan Wake's house is gone. Oh,
they call the Sandman.
That's it. That's the game. Woo!
Just a sprinkle stardust and a whisper.
All right.
Go to sleep. Everything.
Do you guys like that game?
I close my eyes. Then I drift away.
Yeah, they do little episodes.
Into the magic.
Should we do episode 2?
I softly say a silent prayer.
I'm seeing 3 people said yes.
Previously on Alan Wake.
Okay, let's see what happened last time.
I came to Bright Falls with my wife, Alice.
Thank you for coming here with me. I thought maybe you could write here.
I don't want to hear it. God damn it, Alice.
Now, she's missing.
Alice? Alice?
I woke up behind the wheel of a crashed car. I'm missing a week. I was attacked by shadowy men straight from a nightmare. The sheriff took me to the lake Alice and I had stayed at. But the cabin had disappeared.
See, I don't even have to recap the game. It recaps in game. This is the first game to recap in game. Now, this was 3 years ago at Alan Wake's house.
Honey, I'm home.
Back here, sweetie. How was it?
Worst weather I've ever seen.
You should put some coffee on. It'll warm you up.
Huh?
Everyone voted for episode 2.
Everyone voted yes?
Hey,
to
handsome.
See more Alan Wake?
This is going to be a long night, all but right. These shots are turning out great.
I guess you're going to need that coffee then. I'll go put it on.
Hey, look, it's Alan Wake. It's just a real guy for Alan Wake. It's just a real man. Dang, it's a blizzard out there.
Coffee's on.
Great, thanks. I'll need it if I'm gonna finish this by tomorrow.
Where's Alan Wake living? What is this, New York? I can't tell. Oh, he just moved in. Oh, no, he's got a new TV. Alan Wake's getting a new TV set up. Go in this room. This is my writing room. This is where I pick all my books. Alan Wake, Return to Sender. Alan Wake, What I Can't Forget. Alex Casey, The Things That I Want. The Fall of Casey. Oh, dang. I want to hear more about the Casey saga. Why does he have golden guns? Why does Alan Wake have 2 golden guns here? Oh, he's got a new book. The Sudden Stop. That's his new book. This is the script for the Alan Wake game. Thank you, big. Oh, eat that. Max Payne. Eat that for health. Put it on my radio.
The continuing freezing rain and heavy snowfall have necessitated a winter storm warning in the entire tri-state area. People are advised to stay indoors as many roadways are already...
The tri-state area.
Officials are not expecting snow crews to keep up with the weather. We're now on the 3rd day of the blizzard, and the weather is not expected to clear up anytime
Bang.
Soon.
What's the tri-state area?
I think it's New York.
New York. New York is the tri-state area.
Oh, hey, I just finished those cover mock-ups. They're on your desk. Tell me what you think.
No kidding. I didn't think you'd get them done this quickly.
On occasion, I can perform all sorts of miracles, my dear.
Dang, this is like me and Leah.
These look really good.
Oh, sure, until Barry gets his hands on them. Which, by the way, will happen over my dead body. The last time was the last time. Oh, and speaking of Barry, he called.
Whoa! Whoa!
Alan, please check the fuse box.
I'm right here. I'm on it, honey.
Please hurry!
Oh! Whoa! Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Honey, it's a power outage. I've got the flashlight.
Okay. Hi.
You okay?
I'm sorry. It just really spooked me.
Don't worry.
Why is she so afraid of the dark?
I know it's stupid, but it's just... Especially when I'm not prepared for it, you know? It gets to me.
I love you.
Tell me a story, Ryder.
Okay. I used to have these nightmares when I was a kid. The dark really spooked me, too. When it got really bad, my mom gave me this old light switch. She called it the clicker.
The clicker, huh?
Yeah. If I ever got scared of the dark, I could just flip the switch and a magic light would scare the monsters away.
Oh, sure.
Here it is.
Alan.
Maybe it'll help you, too.
Yeah, nice story, Ryder boy. You made that up right now, didn't you?
No. Seriously.
I love you, even if you are a liar. Thanks for this.
How do you feel, Mr. Wick? Any nausea, disorientation, anything like that? Mr. Wake, how are you feeling?
I'm awake.
I'm okay. My head's fine. I had to lie about my headache and memory loss. He'd send me to a hospital for tests. I couldn't leave without Alice.
Very well. I don't think you have a concussion, but you've obviously been through quite a shock. You should take it easy for a couple of days.
Thanks.
Well then, Mr. Wake, we're done here. If the pain gets any worse or you experience any other symptoms, you should come see me. I'll let you get on with it then. Sarah, Sheriff Breaker, is waiting for you. She's very good at her job. I'm sure she can locate your wife in no time.
She fell in the lake by a house, off of a house that doesn't exist.
Sheriff Breaker had called him to the station to take a look at the cut in my head.
You caught a fish.
I'm sorry you had to cut your morning fishing short for this, Doc.
Oh, she's a beauty, ain't she? Not the biggest I ever caught, if you can believe that coming from an old fisherman like me, but she's right up there. Now, she's a largemouth bass, which is what you're after if you prefer a lure. Now, if you want either trout or salmon, on the other hand, then it's fly fishing for you. You a fishing man, Mr. Wake? Oh, doesn't really matter, I suppose, but it can be very relaxing out there. You can't get me off the water this time of year. Closest thing to heaven.
I'll take your word for it, Doc.
Okay, now, Doctor. Tell me about this computer. Tell me about this. Doctor, tell me about this chair.
I believe you'll find the sheriff in her office. Just go down the corridor.
Oh, I'm at the sheriff's station.
Thank you for testing the lights, Miss Weaver. Everything seems to be fine.
I don't have the luxury of being complacent, Deputy Grant. The bulbs will need changing soon. You can't change them in the dark.
Be sure to take care of it, Miss Weaver. Have a nice day now.
Very good. I'll come back later on to remind you, just in case.
Flashlight lady.
Mr. Wake? The sheriff is waiting for you in her office down the corridor.
I'm going the other way.
That was Cynthia Weaver. I guess you can call her the town eccentric. She used to be the editor of the local newspaper, but she's focused on other things these days.
She'd fit right in where I come from.
As you can see, she's a little obsessed with maintaining the light bulbs of the whole town, refuses to step on shadows, things like that. Back in her day, she wrote about all sorts of weird things in the paper. Bright Falls has a colorful history. Of course, what small town hasn't?
I got attacked by a shadow man and I shot him 100 times. Go in here. Where's the evidence room? Let's find where they keep all the guns.
Yeah, it's Mulligan here. I'm at Stuckey's gas station with Thornton. There's no sign of him. Over.
Wait. I shot him off a cliff.
Thornton. Look, we've located the parade float. It's here. That's some good news, right? Stuckey was supposed to be driving it at the rehearsal.
The sheriff
today.
Wants to see you in her office, Mr. Wake.
Come in, Mr. Wake. Your phone's on the desk. The battery was dead. It's charged now.
Stucky's also dead. I shot him.
Have you started looking for my wife yet?
My men are already on it. Now, can you tell me what happened?
I'm not sure. I can't remember. We were arguing. I walked out of the cabin.
The cabin on Cauldron Lake?
How did you end up at Stucky's gas station?
I wanted to tell her what had happened last night, but I couldn't. She'd lock me up. Excuse me, I need to take this. Hello?
Alan, please help me.
Alice?
Stop talking to the law. You'll do exactly what I say if you ever want to see your wife again.
Who is this?
Go to the back lot. There's a hole in the fence on the left. Look inside the junker. I left a little something there to convince you we're all on the same page here. After you ditch the cops, you're gonna meet me in Elderwood National Park. There's a spot called Lover's Peak. Midnight. Don't do nothing stupid, pal.
Mr. Wade, can I help you with anything?
I need to get some air. The sheriff said I could go out back.
Of course, Mr. Wake. You can get there through the cell corridor. Just don't mind Walter in there. He's one of our regulars.
Hey, mister! Hey, can you turn the light? The light's on!
No!
The deputies, they won't...
No!
They don't understand. They won't listen to me. I
need this page.
Right in here.
Thank you.
The early morning light hurt my eyes and made my head ache.
The early
the man
bird
on the phone
gets
said,
to worm.
Go through the fence on the left.
Morpheus, where do I go? Kick that. Yeah, kick this shit.
Alice's driver's license had been placed on the front seat.
What?
The caller meant business.
Barry?
Ow! Thank God! Where the hell have you been? I've been trying to reach you for a week, you and Alice. Oh, I've been worried sick. I flew out yesterday. I'm here in Bright Falls.
Thank
Barry,
you,
listen
Slim
to me. I'm
chief.
At the sheriff's station. Come and get me. I can't talk now.
Ow! What the hell is going on?
I had to get the sheriff to let me go. I needed
to
get to Elderwood National Park to meet Alice's kidnappers.
Okay. So let me do a recap. So Alan Wake, he goes to Twin Peaks. Shadow Woman hands him the key to a house that's not real, and they go there with his wife. But his wife jumps in the lake because the house ate her, and the house doesn't exist. And he is on TV and the Twilight Zone is on TV, and he's on TV, and he has to write the book to bring his wife back, and his wife is kidnapped. And he killed that guy. He killed like 50 guys already. Alright, we're caught up.
A writer is a light that reveals the world of his story from darkness, shapes it from nothingness. The way a sculptor carves a statue from a block of granite. If I stop, the world I'm making dies. Darkness will reclaim it. It's a long, hard journey into the dark. Alice's life is at stake, but I can't think about that, or I'll lose it. The dread lingers at the edge of perception. I'll push on. Anything is possible here. I'll write the story. I'll save her.
Oh, okay.
Marvelous, Sarah. I
just wanted to settle all the damage the Anderson brothers might have inadvertently caused on their recent and regrettable little outing. They are not accountable for their actions, of course. I can assure you that my staff has been reprimanded.
Tor and Odin never caused any trouble to anyone when they were still living at their farm.
Indeed. All we can do is to slow down the progress of their dementia.
Are you feeling any better, Mr. Wake?
I'd like to leave. Am I free to go?
Well, we still need to talk about...
Am I under arrest?
No, of course not. But I need to know where you'll be staying so I can get in touch with you.
I'd avoid the motel. The Majestic is known for its roaches. The cabins at Elderwood are pretty nice, though.
That sounds perfect.
I'm Dr. Emil Hartman. I'd like to invite you to stay at Cauldron Lake Lodge.
Did you talk to my wife?
I had the pleasure of discussing your situation with her on several occasions.
Did you set something up with her?
I invited her here. My clinic is a place where...
Oh!
Take it easy.
Alan Wake is crazy.
Hey, nobody move. Get your hands off of my client.
Who are you?
I'm Barry Wheeler, his agent. If you have business with Mr. Wake, you talk to me. You yokels won't know what hit you once I sick my lawyers on your asses.
No harm done, Sarah. I'm all right. I don't want to press charges. Mr. Wake, my offer still stands.
Get me out of here.
Damn, the Wake is going crazy.
What the hell was that about, Al? We don't need a replay of that thing with the paparazzi. I thought they were gonna lock you up.
I had to talk to someone. I told Barry everything. He thought I was certifiable, but when he heard about the manuscript, I had him. The fact that I'd written something, even if I couldn't remember it, was enough for him. He smelled money, and he believed that Alice had been kidnapped. Anything beyond that was another story. I had a midnight appointment with the kidnapper in a place called Lover's Peak, somewhere in Elderwood National Park.
Alan Wake just dumped the whole storyline on his agent.
I don't like it, Al. I don't like any of it. It's not good. In fact, it's the absolute opposite of good.
Mr. Wake! Barry, you found him!
Hi, Rose.
Oh, wow. I was just thinking about you, too.
Great.
I was just bringing Rusty some coffee. He's on the balcony, looking after Max. Poor thing. I really need to go. Great to see you again, Mr. Wake. Later!
Who's Max?
Agent's scared.
Jeez, Mr. takes a swing at everybody. This is not her fault. She's a very nice girl and, more importantly, a fan.
It's Bucktooth Charlie.
Dedicated to you.
We found him. It's Bucktooth Charlie. He was 14,000 years old. He was recovered from the La Brea tar pits in 1981. He was donated in 1998 when the mammoth became Washington State fossil. Okay. Well, we solved one mystery. Timeline of evolution. Okay, so first we were this guy. Then we were crab. Then we turned into a starfish. Then we were a dinosaur. Then an alligator. Then we were elephant. And then elephant transformed into a lion. Thank you.
Seriously, Al, what you were saying in the car? Just listen to yourself. What, you shot a guy and his body just disappeared? When was the last time you slept? What, are you high? Have you been drinking?
No! Look, Barry, I'm missing a week, and someone's got Alice.
Do you understand what it sounds like when you say stuff like that? Don't get me wrong, it's a good story, could be a bestseller. But when you start confusing fiction with reality, you're buying yourself a ticket to the funny farm.
Wait here.
It's a video game. It's all in a video game.
Easy there, boy. I'm almost done.
Doggy.
Hey, Rusty, right? You rent cabins.
Oh, Mr. Wake. I'd shake your hand, but mine are kind of full here. Actually, I'm sorry about this. Would you mind grabbing the registration form from the desk? It's just across from Bucktooth Charlie.
Okay, sure.
This is Bucktooth Charlie.
Crazy poachers. Max here got his foot caught in a trap. They're illegal to use here. Hell, you're not supposed to hunt within the park at all. But that doesn't stop some lowlifes. Well, at least Max is going to be okay. He got lucky.
Oh, I thought this was Toby. This
Max
is a different dog.
From the shot I gave him, and I'd rather not leave him alone just
Al,
yet.
You can't
the
just go and...
This guy's still talking.
Those situations always end up in disaster. You gotta talk to the cops.
Why am I...
She's my wife, and it's my call. Can we talk about this later?
No. This whole...
I gotta go find the doggy.
Listen, you hit your head.
Here, doggy, sign this.
This is the form you wanted?
And here are the keys. Okay, you're all set, Mr. Wake. Glad to have you staying here.
Thanks. Can you tell me how to get to Lover's Peak?
Oh, sure. It's at the end of the nature trail. Just follow the paths, you'll get to it eventually. It's an easy walk. Nice spot, too.
Okay, so we didn't find Toby. So there's still a couple mysteries out.
Freak me out? It's working. Ha ha! Let's have a laugh on Barry. Well, you had me going there real funny, Al. You can quit it now. Look, Al, you're asking me to believe that you shot a dude who went poof into thin air, a guy who was bulletproof until you pointed a...
I did do that. I did do all that. You guys saw. You guys saw. I did do all that.
Al. Al? We should go to the sheriff or call the FBI.
Damn it, Barry. They'll kill her. This is not a goddamn debate, Barry. I'm going to Lover's Peak.
Weak ass slinger.
Okay then. I understand. You're my best friend, and I'm worried that you're not right in the head. Tell me what to do to help, and I'll do it.
You stay here, and if I'm not back by morning, call the cavalry.
When you really piss Alan Wake off, he knocks the lamp over.
Just be careful with the natives, Al. These yokels are dangerous. Everybody hates a tourist, or it'll be deliverance all over again.
Bless you.
Wait, are we back in Alan Wake's house? Wait, what? No, this is a different... This is not the same. This is a different one. Let me turn the lights on. Going to Lover's Peak.
I'll wait here, Al. I'll hold down the fort. I'll be with you in spirit every step of the way, Al. Watching the door now.
Barry had the keys to the car he rented. Wasn't a long walk to the visitor center, and it wouldn't be any use to me in the forest.
What? Drive!
I knew I should have gone to the cops. This wasn't the smartest thing I'd ever done, but I was still angry with Barry for trying to talk me out of it. These people had called me right in the sheriff's station. The cops wouldn't scare them, and they had Alice.
Yeah. I think it's safer for Alan Wake to go. He killed like 50 dudes.
Welcome back to the show, folks. As promised, our very own Dr. Nelson has just parked his rear end in the studio.
Oh, Dr. Nelson is here. Okay.
My plan? You make it sound a lot more organized than I ever seem to manage. No, really, just taking the atmosphere. I'm getting a little too rickety to do much more than that, you know. Oh, tell me about it. No sack race for us older gentlemen, huh?
No sack race.
Yeah, exactly. But I'm going to check out the parade, of course. And I'll be one of the pie contest judges, too. Well, that takes a different kind of constitution. Oh, yeah. It's my kind of exercise. Now, Doc, seriously, you're in pretty good shape, though. You're the outdoors guy. I know for a fact.
Why are they interviewing the doctor about fishing on the radio?
Just caught a heck of a largemouth bass early this morning. But you're not taking part in the fishing contest? No, not this year. See, Pat, I'm just not that
competitive anymore. Now I just like to take my time and enjoy the peace of it. It's no fun if I need to worry about what I'm catching, you know?
Well, considering your track record, the participants are probably pretty happy you feel that way.
Well, Pat, that's kind of you to say.
Alan Wake is supposed to be going to a ransom meeting, but instead he just goes into a random person's house and starts listening to the doctor talk about his fishing again on the radio. You never know what's going to happen in this game. You never know where the story's head next. Drop hazard. Oh, look at this now. That's... Whoa! Whoa! Alan Wake! This tire controls the whole world! Oh, no, it doesn't. I think that was just a coincidence. Alan Quake. That was an Alan Quake. Oh, let's go to Moonshine Cave. I'm going to Moonshine Cave. Now, one second, guys. Before I go there, let's see if my show's in. Put my show in. Here we go.
Crime and Punishment. The Cancer and Cure of Civilization. But some crimes are impossible to punish.
Dangerous.
In Night Springs. Tonight's episode. The Man in the Mirror.
Oh, this one is scary. This one is scary.
He's inside, Agent. He's a weird one.
So, you're confessing to killing that guy, huh? Why?
Had it coming?
Yeah, but why would you do that? I mean, you're a nice guy. Normal. Took your kid to a soccer game. So how come at the game, you pick a guy and, quoting from the arresting officer's report here, assault the victim's head area repeatedly with the weapon of choice being a pair of bare fists? Wow, that sentence really flows, huh? Maybe you're not the literary type. Okay, so you mess him up. But why? Who was that guy? We couldn't ID him. Why would a guy like you do him like that?
I didn't like his face?
Well, you must have hated it, because you really went to town there. I mean, there's no way to tell what he looked like. No ID on him either.
That must be difficult.
But then we ran the fingerprints. Got a match. Your prints. Identical.
Huh, how about that?
Your son said you were wearing a white shirt when you took him to the game. But the white shirt is on the dead guy.
It's plenty red now.
You won't get away with this.
Do you really think that's in any way relevant to me? I had plenty of time to talk to my boy before the cops arrived, you know? He won't stop screaming, am I right? You think he's ever gonna be okay? I left my mark. Believe me.
You bastard.
What? You gonna shoot me? What's the point? I'm going to prison. You got me.
I don't understand any of this.
And you never will. Don't worry. Maybe you'll see me again, Agent. Maybe in the mirror.
Whoa. What? What happened? That twist, it went way too crazy. Don't ever go into that bird's house. The birds watch a crazy episode of that show. He just goes to prison. The guy just goes to prison and then that's it. Thank you. The flashlight stays on forever? Yeah. And like, he likes to take this flashlight on with him. He likes to take this everywhere he goes. Give me that page, thank you. The light, it lasts forever until you actually need it. Then it lasts. Oh!
The vision left me weak. This was no head injury.
I'll save you, Rusty. I'll save you. I'm coming to save you, doggy.
Help me. Can you hear me? Anyone? Please. Hello? Help.
It's me, Alan Wake.
I'm back here.
What is all this blood?
Mr. Wake? Hell, it happened just the way it was on that page. I found came true. It knew. So dark. It'll come back for me. You must. The lights in the office. I have the key.
Okay, Rusty. Hang on. I'll be right back.
I don't think he's gonna live.
Whoever did this couldn't be far. Rusty had found a page from the manuscript. It would help me understand what had happened.
He bleeded like all the blood that he has out already. Rusty dying. Let's read this.
The air in the visitor center was heavy with an awful smell, as if some rotten drowned thing had crawled up from its grave. Rusty kept coughing blood. My eyes were drawn to the twisted shape of his broken leg. The attack had been vicious. Max whined in his cage. Rusty's eyes were wild with fear and terror. He gasped. Mr. Wake, it happened just the way it was on that page.
I remember when this happened. This was like 7 seconds ago.
The only way to make sure that Rusty was safe was to get the power running and the lights back on.
Is that a bear? Alright. I'll get to the bottom of this mystery. Then we're gonna save Toby.
I was too late.
Oh, shit.
Someone had destroyed the circuit breaker. There was no way to get the lights back on.
He's okay.
The ground was covered with oily patches that looked like liquid darkness.
Oh fuck, liquid darkness. Uh-oh. Zombie. Shoot him. Is the guy still alive? Is he still alive, you think?
Something had torn a mammoth-sized hole in the wall.
Please don't feed the animal.
Is he still alive? Yeah, he's probably still alive.
Purchase a park. License, obey!
The park ranger's instructions.
At all times.
No. Whoa, he's fast guy. Oh, fast guy.
Do bears and wolves never approach any other wildlife closer than
45 yards?
Pets must be leashed.
Get this guy. Come on, Alan Wake. Kill this guy. This guy is super fast. God, he's so fast. Get him. Get him. Yeah. Yeah, don't tell me the rules. Don't you tell me the rules. You're out of there. Wait, was that the guy that we were trying to save? Did I just shoot his head off? Oh! That was him? Alan Wake just shooting everybody in the whole town. Uh-oh. Yeah, where'd the dog go? Wait. Let's go back. Where'd the dog go? We gotta find the dog. I think the dog is still, he's still safe. You're thinking the dog is the mastermind behind it all? Like Silent Hill? Yeah, the dog is missing. Oh, could be the dog. Right now, these are my theories. Theory one, this whole thing is a Alan Wake dream. Then at the end of the game, he wakes up and goes, well, now I'm Alan Wake. Theory two, dog did it. It's an evil dog pulling the strings.
What the hell was that? I saw from the window. I saw something.
Forget about it, Barry. It's just me going crazy.
Oh, jeez. You're not crazy. I wish you were crazy, but you're not crazy. Ow, be careful.
Stay in the cabin. Don't open the door for anyone. I mean it.
Theory three, Barry is behind it. He's behind it all. Oh, manuscript. I unlocked manuscript. Let's see, what's a funny one? What's a funny part of the book? Wait, what should we read? Wake feels the dark presence? Or Wake hears a chainsaw? These are my two favorite parts. Alright, let's do Wake feels the dark. Oh, a lot of people want chainsaw. Alright. Let's hear about when Alan Wake heard the chainsaw.
The night had been one desperate situation after another. I was exhausted, and my body felt as though it had been chewed up and spat out. The flashlight was heavy in my hand, and each pull of the trigger sent a painful shock up my arm. But I was finally out of the woods, and things were looking up. That's when I heard the chainsaw.
Oh, shit! That's when he heard it! This is a good book. This book is getting better all the time. Theory 4, this is all a TV show. This is a very elaborate episode of, what's the Twilight Zone show called in the show?
Lover's Peak was at the far end of the nature trail.
No, don't go there. Go to Moonshine Cave. That's where the treasure is. Night Springs, yeah. This is all just an episode of Night Springs. Moonshine Cave, site of frequent bootlegger activity throughout Prohibition. This is where they used to illegally make moonshine. Who was enforcing prohibition out here? There's only like 10 people. There was probably only 3 people back in that time. Climb up that rack. Come on. Get up there. Get up that rack. There you go. Yeah, the moonshine people left, they left AA's. Those have been there since the 30s. Oh, they're coming to get him. And I'm like, run. Whoa! Dang, this game has dodging in a shooting game. This game predates Last of Us 2. This is the first shooting game to have dodge. This is the first shooting game to have a flashlight and a dodge button. And it's the first shooting game to have Alan Wake as a character. Alan predates. First shooting game with Barry, that's true. Actually, didn't Silent Hill 2 have Barry? Wasn't that the name of the guy that eats pizza? I think that was the first shooting game to have Barry. Although you could argue that Silent Hill isn't really a shooting game. I don't even know if you get a gun in it. Just hitting stick. Now this is the great Deku tree. This you go in here for me and do it. Oh, whoa, whoa. Whoa, you almost tried to get me. You tried to get me? You tried to get me, and now you're out of here. Thanks for playing. I have to get to Lover's Cave. Now stand in the flashlight. Nope, nope. Nope. I have a whole strategy to do this. You just blind them. You blind them with the big beam, and you just shine them with this little beam. Oh! Fuck! Wait! Oh no, I'm running low on batteries. I need to make it to that light. Alan Wake, run! Run! Go! Go! Oh! No! Go, Alan Wake, go! Get to that light! You cannot kill me! You cannot kill me! Ah! Run! I made it. Fuck, it turned off! It turned off! Oh no! Shit, turn it on! Turn it on! Turn it on! Yeah! Yeah, that was close. I have 1 bullet left. 1 battery and 1 bullet left. Oh, new page. Rusty attacked by the dark presence? So many classic pages. Let's do this. The sudden stop too? All right. Tumbleweb specifically requested this page.
This was a late goodbye. 13 years after I'd gotten my revenge, it had finally caught up with me.
It's fucking Max Payne.
It had been a long time to bear the pain. My blood painted the snow red. A gruesome slushy dissolved all the scattered painkillers and leisurely dripped down to the sewer, mingling with the bile of the city, becoming one with it. I can see them now, my wife and my baby. Honey, I'm home.
It's Max Payne on there. What the fuck is this? Alan Wake wrote Max Payne? Dang, this storyline is getting crazy. Alan Wake actually wrote Max Payne. It was actually a graphic novel that he wrote. This storyline is getting fucking crazy. Oh shit, here they come to kill me. Shoot that man. There's too many. Oh, fuck. No. This is too many guys. Get the shotgun out.
Whoa.
Come on, Alan Wake. Come on. You got this. No, fuck. Bam. It didn't work. Fuck. I'm gonna die. Run. What's happening? Flash him. Go. Get to light. Okay, I win. Shit, wait, now how do you get through here? Climb that rack. There you go. Alright, new page. Let's see what's going on with Max Payne.
It's true what they say about the fall and the sudden stop at the end. I'd lain here in the snow while the lurid chain of scenes that had led me here kept playing in my head. A rerun of my own private snuff movie. A memory of my corpse. Alone at my own wake, thinking in metaphors again.
Wake!
The femme fatale was gone. Only a sour taste remained of the kiss that killed me.
Alone is awake. Have I asked why the light makes you win? Well, light is symbolic. Light is symbolic of, like, bright light. It really makes you think. I think it's like Max Payne is involved, and it's like the dog is involved. Or it's just a big dream. Or he has like a backstory where like a light bulb killed him. Like he was killed by Alan Wake was like killed by a light bulb. Birds! Does that guy have a sword? No! Oh! Oh! He's saved!
Come on, we gotta get moving.
Oh, it's the guy that hates Alan Wake.
That flashlight's kid stuff. The flares will keep the bastards away.
That flashlight is kid shit. It's the guy that hates Alan Wake.
You can see them too?
Hell, of course I see them. Come on, we gotta move.
Why?
Because that's the way the story goes.
Yeah, but...
Let's move!
I lost my gun back there.
Oh, I've got a gun. Just keep that light steady on him.
It took a moment, but then I recognized him. He'd been on the ferry when I first arrived here with Alice.
That's the guy who hates Alan Wake.
We were headed in the direction of Lover's Peak. There was no way this was a coincidence. He was the kidnapper.
He's the kidnapper? This is a good story, man. It's like an insane twist every 3 seconds. Yeah, get him. Get him. Yeah, yeah. Shoot that guy. Get him. Now shoot this guy. Get him. Shoot, actually shoot him. Actually shoot him now. Actually, yeah, there you go. Who the fuck did that? No. For this guy, you take that. Now give me my badge. Are we winning?
Lover's Peak, right up these stairs, Wake. Use the flares from the emergency box to hold them off while I get these boards off.
Give me the gun.
Yeah, no can do, Wake.
Are you kidding? Give me the gun.
No time for backtalk. Hold them off, damn it.
Stay away. Stay away.
Just a little longer. Scare him off.
Boo. I am Alan Wake.
Get some light on those bastards. That'll keep them off us.
Yeah. Take this. Take this, you bastards.
Just a little longer. I almost got it.
All right. I'll do it. Ow, you ass! Take this. Yeah. Take this, you bastard guys. Shoot this guy. Here I go again. Yeah. Oh, you opened it. We win. Checkpoint.
Oh, you feeling better now, Wake? All cozy and safe.
What kind of flares go out that fast? Well, you have to remember, this stuff has been sitting here. All of this was placed here in the 30s. This is really old flares and batteries from the 1930s.
This is it, Wake. The last stand. There's more flares here. Get ready. We fight them as long as they keep coming.
Give me the goddamn gun. They're coming.
That's not how this goes. Get with the program, Wake.
Opinion on the game? It's really fun so far. Wait, I get a gun? No, I don't get a gun. Shoot that guy. Now shoot this guy. Shoot. Shoot his head off. Shoot his wiener off. Yeah, get him. Get him. Now shoot this guy. Try shooting him in the hand. Shoot his hand. Try shooting him in the hand. There you go. This is a piece of cake, Wake. This is like almond cake. You piss me off. Take this. Feel the power of my 7-second lasting flare. This guy sucks ass at shooting. Look at this guy sitting here. Fuck! Fuck! Oh no, I'm gonna die! Take this! Shoot them! You're so bad at shooting! Shoot that guy. Now shoot this dumb guy. Come on. No! He's ramming! Shoot him! Yeah! I think the problem with this game is they're just...
Where's my wife?
It gets to be so much shooting.
I read it all before. You're a hell of a writer. Congratulations. You're gonna bring about something glorious and terrible once we get you some proper editorial control.
I think the story is more fun than the shooting.
Where's Alice?
I want the entire manuscript or she's gonna suffer bad.
You touch her off.
He punched him again! Oh, what the fuck? Alan Wake is always punching everyone. Get the gun. You'll never get my manuscript. It's about Max Payne.
You're gonna give me the manuscript or you'll be sorry.
No, you'll never get the manuscript.
Come back here. I swear I'll kill you if you hurt Alice. Do you hear me? Come back here.
What if Alan Wake gives him the Alan Wake gives him the manuscript? It's just all about fucking Max Payne. The guy just gets pissed off and shoots Alan Wake. The guy thinks the manuscript is the key to everything, and then he just gets the pages. It's just all fucking Max Payne shit. Oh, don't step in that. Actually, to be funny though.
What the hell?
Oh, fuck. Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay. That was funny. But now let's not step in anymore. There. Why is there so many? How do you actually use a bear trap? You just have one with like a stake on it. Oh fuck. What are they trying to accomplish with like 50 bear traps? Are they just trying to wipe out bears from the whole forest? They're trying to catch 50 bears. Some ass guy is just trying to catch 50 bears in a row. Shit, how do I get over there? I'm gonna have to jump into Alan Lake. Right? Jump down. Oh, he's actually trying to catch one really smart bear. That makes sense. There's so many twists in the storyline. First, I thought it was going to be about Alan Wake's wife. Then it was like a TV show. Now it's like we're trying to find the dog. And there's like a storyline of like a bear, like a really smart bear. And we have to find a manuscript. And Max Payne is involved now. Holy shit! Stop that! Stop that! Boom! 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 Get out of here! Go, Alan Wake, go! We have to solve the mystery of who took Toby. What if this? I have a theory. Now this goes back to the episode of... What's the show called again? Twin Zone? Remember the episode, The Man in the Mirror. Okay, one second. Remember the episode, The Man in the Mirror. Now notice how there's two dogs. There was one dog, then there was Toby. We never saw Toby. Dual dogs. Duality. There's clones. Clones are involved. Alan Wake is two people. Ah! Batteries. I have a new clone theory. Theory 5 is the clone theory. Oh, now we have the hunting rifle. I think the most realistic theory is that it's all a dream. That's the dumbest, but also that's the one that they'll probably go with. The one that I'm least expecting is the clone theory. This is a very poorly founded theory. But also, it could be right. We'll have to see. Oh! Oh, motherfucker! Run! 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 Oh my god! They kill you quick. Shoot, Alan Wake, shoot. Shoot these people. Fuck. Get him. Get him. Shoot him, shoot him. Where am I? Ow! Where the fuck is Toby? I wanna put on an episode of the show now. Where's my show? Oh! Fuck! Shit! Shit! Oh fuck! Oh no! He dies. Oh no! I'm all the way back here? Oh no!
Oh no! Here, let's. What does these do? Put this. Okay, these are powerful. Oh, and wait, go. Oh, you can sprint. That's what I'm doing wrong. You can actually sprint. Boom. Start the thing. There we go. Whoop. Okay, now that I have sprinting, now I'm very powerful. Oh no, he runs out of sprint though, really fast. Time to wake up. Evil guy. Made it to the building finally. I don't know why am I at a mill? I thought we were going back to Barry. I'm so busy thinking about like the 12 different twists that I never even understand how we're just in the moment to moment part of the story. Oh shit, the evil slime. Oh, this gives a little more weight to my evil slime theory. Alan Snake? Wait. Alan Snake? Wait, this gives me a new theory. What if he's a snake? Let's listen to the classic page. Wake feels the dark presence.
Shadows stirred and the wind picked up as I ran through the forest. I felt the dark presence turning its gaze toward me. Then the moonlight was blotted out by dark shadows that raced violently across the ground, moving too swiftly to be natural. Darkness gathered between the trees and melted again to reveal the Taken. No natural path had brought them here.
Oh. That's scary. Thank you, Johnny. Oh my God, it's the hype train. Thank you, everyone. Thank you, everybody on the hype train. I'm so glad the people are finally getting hyped for Alan Wake. Kicked it. Yeah. Jump on there. Oh, it's a page. Boom. Oh. Fuck. Wait, what just happened? What do I do? Go on this? Jump in. All right, now go. Activate. This is the first elevator. This was one of the first elevators. It sucks ass.
Ah! I keep getting hit by this slime. That is really powerful slime. Kick this door down. That doesn't work. Alright. We're doing our first ever gameplay where the solution isn't to shoot somebody in the head. Now the game is actually getting really hard. Maybe I can shoot the entire mill in the head? That's what I'm thinking right now. Oh, I see what you do. You just jump here. Fuck! God damn it. It's this slime again. That slime always gets you. This slime spot on the ground is one of the toughest enemies of this game. That slime has dealt more damage than the boss did. Yeah. Okay, now this. Now we're in business. Boom, get the flares. Now we're talking. Okay. Wait, were we in here before? No, I don't think we were in here. There we go. Read more of the manuscript? Alright. I know how much you guys love the manuscript. Let's read Wake Sees the Torch Symbol. Now, this is one of those landmark twists where everybody remembers where they were when Alan Wake saw the torch symbol.
I turned the corner, afraid of what the flashlight's beam might reveal. Suddenly, a roughly painted symbol of a torch glowed in the light. Behind it, hidden by a rock, sat a battered metal trunk. It was here for a reason. Packed with supplies, batteries, flares, ammo. Things you need to make it through the darkness of the night. Something left behind by someone who knew what I knew, and more.
Yeah, that's a classic. Every time you hear that page, it gets better.
Beware of Widowmakers!
Whoa! He had good advice, though. He said, be aware of Widowmakers. Leah told me about Widowmakers. It's a tree branch that falls down and hits you on the head and kills you. So when you're out walking, watch out for a tree branch that'll fall down and hit you on the head and kill you. Also Overwatch, yes. If you see Widowmaker on your team in Overwatch, try to leave the match. Try to leave. Huh?
You're always Widowmaker in my match.
Yeah, I always pick Widowmaker. I always pick Widowmaker, and I still haven't gotten a kill on her. that guy in the way. Alan Page. Oh, that's a good one. Maybe she'll be in the game. I left a manuscript page behind. That's okay. It was probably just one about the game Quantum Break. We don't have to read any of those. Bad though. Take this. Get him. Yeah, yeah. Face the power of this. Shit, he has a lot of power. Face the power of this gun. Boom. Yeah. Oh, a chainsaw. This takes me back to the manuscript page. Alan Wake, here's a chainsaw. A lot of people in chat weren't around for that. That was a big one. A lot of the stream old timers, you guys know what I'm talking about. A lot of the newbies just coming in, you guys don't know. But the old timers, you guys know what I'm talking about. Alan Wake, here's a chainsaw.
Barry?
Legendary.
Stay out of sight. I'm on my way. Don't open the door. Stay hidden. I'll be there soon. Just make sure you keep the lights on.
Oh, this is the birdie battle. I remember this. I remember this page in the manuscript.
But at least I was out of the woods.
Birdie battle.
I'd have to get the car from the locked garage. It would get me back to Barry faster, and the headlights were a welcome bonus.
Oh, headlights. Oh, this is very powerful, actually. Alan Wake should just stay in his car the whole time. He would be extremely powerful. I'm going in the evil bathroom. Oh, my show's back on. My show's back on.
What you tell it. A story is a beast with a life of its own. You can create it, shape it, but as the story grows, it starts wanting things of its own. Change one thing and you set off a chain reaction of events that spreads through the whole thing. The characters have to be true to themselves. The events need to follow a logic that fits the story. A single flaw and the magic is gone. The story dies. Alice dies.
That's true. That's actually true. Motherfucker, guy! Get out of here! Right there, Alan Wake wrote. And then the Shadow Man jumps out of the bathroom. He wrote that in the manuscript. Oh, you can drive. Fuck you! Yeah! You can boost the lights. Light boost. Boom! Oh, I can do a light boost. Hey, fuck you! Hey, fuck you! Boom! Oh my god! This is awesome. Hey, fuck you! Hey, fuck you!
Whee! Go off the ramp! Oh yeah, big air, big air! This is great. You should just be in the car for the rest of the game. Whee! Oh, truck, you want a battle? Hey, fuck you! Hey, I bet they're in here. Die! Die! Alright, they're not. I'm coming to save you, Barry. Thank you, Power Palooza. Where are you, Barry? I'll save you. Where am I? What's happening? I'm saving you. Barry. It's hard to steer this truck. This truck, like, it's really wacky. No, fuck. This is bullshit.
The flare gun was probably the best weapon I could imagine against the dark things I was facing.
Oh, flare gun. Oh. Come and face me. I'll sprawl you guys. Come on. What? Where'd they go? Oh, I stepped into this.
It was the kidnapper.
You son of a bitch! Where's my wife?
Enough horseplay, Wake. You deliver the manuscript, and you can have your woman back. Simple as that.
I don't... Listen. I'm gonna need time to finish it. I still need to write the ending. I need a week.
It's not done.
I need a week.
2 days. The old Bright Falls coal mine is nearby. You can find it easy, city boy. The main building, there at noon. You bring the manuscript, you'll get your wife. If not, well, get me.
Yes, I get you.
Okay, let me just watch my show now. Oh, it's not in this one. So Alan Wake now has to write the rest of the whole story in 2 days. Somebody recap Victor. Victor needs a recap. Somebody recap him real quick in the chat. Somebody do a quick rundown on the twist and the theories.
Ow! Ow, I am so glad you're here. A couple of them got in here before I blocked the chimney. This isn't normal. These birds are weird.
I'll save you, Barry. I'll save Barry from the birds. Now I have to save Barry from the birds. Oh, there's a lot of birds. This is a lot. Oh! You can never face me, birds. I dare you to face me. Oh, here they come. Oh! Yeah! Take this! Birdie battle. This'll get him. This is the first shooting game where you have to fight birds as an enemy. Nowadays, we're so used to having birds as an enemy. Back then, this was the only... Oh! Oh, birds! Shoot those birds! This and Duck Hunt, those were the only games where you fought birds. Shoot that damn bird! They're winning. The birds are winning this battle. Fuck! Shit! The birds are hard! Boom! Okay. We need that. We need more of that. Oh, fuck. Here they come. Boom! Did it work? Fuck! Fuck! Take this! I need more flare gun. More flare gun ammo. Shit! These birds are actually gonna win.
You can open the door now. They're gone.
Oh, I won. I won. Oh, here. Take those. Open up, Barry.
Hey, Al. I'm sorry for thinking you were having a psychotic episode, man.
I sent Barry to the town to ask around about a man fitting the kidnapper's description. He'd go through the archives of the local paper. Perhaps he could learn something. Anything about the island and the cabin that had disappeared. The man wanted a manuscript. I had to try to write him one to get Alice back.
Can't look. Like punch the book.
It's been nothing but a metaphor for the human psyche, a tool to use in writing fiction. Now it was happening for real, and I couldn't put a single word on paper.
Alan Wake punches everybody. He even punched the book.
Barry Wheeler speaking.
This is Rose.
Rose?
I found Mr. Wake.
Oh, you sweet, brilliant girl.
Could you and Mr. Wake come get them? I live in the trailer park outside the town.
We'll be there in less than an hour.
I know.
See you soon.
She found it.
Have a great day. Hope you come back soon. Welcome to the Old Deer Diner.
Good girl.
Oh, shit. That's Alan Wake. Thanks for watching, everybody. Can you tell me where I am? That's it. That's the end. Won't you say something? All right, I'm going to sleep. We'll play more Alan Wake later. That's a great storyline. I think maybe the dog did it. We'll find out next time. Good night, everybody. I'm going Alan asleep. I'm going to be Alan sleep.